Hello everyone and welcome to this video on the H1 figures for the EDAG Engineering Group AG. These figures have been presented by our management already earlier this morning. However, if you have not been able to attend to the meeting, this is your chance to get an overview on the essentials. By way of introduction, I am Sebastian Lehmann, Head of Investor Relations here at the EDAG Group. Before we get started, and as usual, please carefully read our legal disclaimer. And then we're going to get started with an overview on the current market environment. Let's start with a macro perspective. The global economy is currently negatively affected by multiple factors, namely the COVID pandemic, which is still ongoing with restrictions in China, but also increased illness rates all over the world. We have the war on Ukraine, which is causing high energy prices in Europe. We have supply chain disruptions, which are continued or sometimes even worse. And finally, the inflation is at a very high level, which made international central banks to raise their interest rates. All over, this development made the IMF to lower the global economic growth expectations at the end of July. So how does this environment now transfer into the automotive industry? We see it kind of a mixed picture. On the one side, we see the suppliers. The suppliers are currently more affected by less volumes that are being produced and sold, which is why their figures are not as good as the figures of the OEMs, because the OEMs on the other side are focusing on high margin cars, but also granting less rebates to their customers. And this makes them transfer or generate very decent margins and high cash flows. Now, the difference between the time right now and the beginning of the corona pandemic is that the OEMs are spending the surplus cash on research and development. So we see very high, sometimes even rising R&D budgets. For example, Mercedes-Benz and Volkswagen have just recently announced to increase their budgets. They are focusing on new technologies like the software-defined car, advanced driver assistance systems, electrification, and battery factories. And this environment transfers into a very decent market for engineering services providers like EDAG. So despite all the current negative factors, the higher level of uncertainty that we see in the macro perspective, we are experiencing a very decent market environment, which transfers into a high number of RFQs, but also a very sound order intake. What this means to our figures, let's go on to the next chart. Here you see the key highlights of the first half 2022. Our revenues are up by almost 15%. The Q2 numbers don't look as good as they appear at first glance because they are up by just 7%. Let me give you 2 points here to explain it. First of all, last year's Q2 was characterized by catch-up effects caused by the cyber attack which we suffered in Q1 last year. So last year's Q2 had a growth of more than 26%. So we had a quite tough comparable basis. And moreover, this year's Q2 had about 4 working days less than this year's Q1. This is why at first glance, these figures look not as good in Q2. Nevertheless, we are almost back to the level pre-crisis, meaning 2019. And another good news is that all of our 3 segments are growing in the first half of this year. Now looking into our adjusted EBIT, you see that it has more than doubled, up to 24.1 million euros. The margin is at 6.3%, and all of our segments have been profitable in Q2, but also the complete H1. And then to give you kind of feeling for what's coming over the next quarters, it's always good to have the order intake as an indicator. And here you see that the order intake was up by about 11%. So another clear indication for the sound market environment, which I characterized before. Let's go a bit more into the details of the numbers. At the next chart, we show our revenue development. On group level, as said, revenues are up by about 15% to 382.2 million euros. If we go to the right side of the chart, you see our 3 segments. Our biggest segment, vehicle engineering, is growing by 6.8%. This is a sound growth, and it is based by a good demand from international, but also domestic clients. Electrics, electronics, this is the segment with the highest growth rates that we currently are posting. And in this segment, you see all the big megatrends or buzzwords like electrification, connectivity features, software development, advanced driver assistance systems, and so on and so on. These megatrends are really driving the revenues in the segment electrics, electronics. And finally, production solutions, a segment which had very hard times over the last at least 2 years, is now finally completely back on the track towards recovery. They are posting a solid increase of 14.2% revenue increase in the first half of this year. Let's go over to the adjusted EBIT. And here you see that it has more than doubled year over year, an increase of 125% to 24 million euros, corresponding a margin of 6.3%. Now, if we go to the right-hand side and look into the segments, you see vehicle engineering is posting the strongest margin of 7.3%. This margin is backed by a high utilization, but also by a good customer and project mix. Electrics Electronics has increased the margin by 1.3 percentage points compared to last year and is now posting a margin of 6.3%, well in line with the group. So why is this margin not as high as in vehicle engineering? This is based mainly on the growth. In electrics, electronics, we are currently heavily investing into future competencies, but also capacities. We've just recently opened a new best cost country facility in Malaysia, where we're going to plan to increase our workforce over the next years. So electrics, electronics is the segment where we put the focus on growth currently to be able to gain market share. And this is why the margin is not as high as in vehicle engineering, but overall fully in line with the group. And then production solutions, you see that last year, the segment was suffering very hard with a margin of minus 7.3%. Here again, comparable to the revenue development, you see that they are definitely on the track of recovery, posting now a positive margin of 1.1%. If we look into our earnings after tax, it is even better than the adjusted EBIT. It has not doubled, it has almost tenfold. The earnings after tax after 6 months are up to almost 14 million euros, and the earnings per share are up to 56 euro cents. Our equity correspondingly went up by about 30 million euros, and the equity ratio is currently at 20.6%. Now let's shortly have a view on our trade working capital. Here you see an increase of about 36 million euros, and the increase is backed by the strong revenue growth. As communicated before, we are building up working capital, especially because we are doing more business with our domestic customers, and we expect this to continue over the next quarters. So, and as we build up working capital, vice versa, the cash flows are going down. They are negative operating, but also free cash flow after 6 months. Nevertheless, if you look into this chart, you see that we have managed to increase the operating, but also the free cash flow, despite the working capital outflow. And for the complete year 2022, we plan to be operating cash flow positive, although this, of course, depends on our project mix by the end of the year. Now, before we come to our outlook, let us have a short view on our net financial debt. As usual, you see two pillars. The left pillar is the net financial debt, including leasing liabilities, and the right pillar is the net financial debt, excluding leasing liability. So if you look at the net financial debt, including leasing liabilities, you see a slight decrease year over year. The overall volume is down to 167.2 million euros. And if you look into the net financial debt, excluding leasing liabilities, you see that they are slightly up to 24 million euros. And this corresponds to a net gearing of just 17.7%. As you see at the very right-hand side, the cash and cash equivalents at the end of the first half of this year were at about 116 million euros. Well, in addition to this, we had more than 105 million euros in available credit lines by the end of the first half. And this means that the EDAG Group is financially strong, but also very flexible to tackle all of the challenges, but also, of course, the opportunities that may come up over the next quarters. So we are now coming to the outlook. And for the complete year 2022, we are still expecting an accelerated growth momentum and a positive development in key performance indicators. However, and please keep this in mind, that this estimation depends largely on the war in Ukraine, possible further geopolitical disputes, as well as ongoing disruptions in global supply chains and further pandemic developments. We are now expecting our revenue to grow at the upper end of a range of around 6 to 9%. The adjusted EBIT margin is expected in a range of around 6 to 8%, and our investment rate is expected in a range of around 4 to 5%. So thank you very much, everyone, for watching this video. Should you have any questions, if you require a call or a meeting, please do not hesitate to contact me. I will be more than happy to support you in any way. Thanks, everyone, and have a good day. Bye-bye.